Hi, it's Steve from sidemounting.com. In this video, we're going to show you more about tired diver towing. So this is somebody who is at the surface and they're in need of your assistance to get back to shore. They're unable to do it themselves due to cramp, tiredness, could be a few things. We've had quite a few of our online subscribers request us to make this video, and I think a lot of you are having difficulty knowing what to do with the fact you're using side mount cylinders, and I think a few of you believe that they get in the way. And hopefully through this video we'll show you it's quite the opposite, and side mount gives you a lot of options and actually, in my opinion, can increase the efficiency should you need to tow somebody. We did cover this initially as part of our rescue training found in the All Divers course, where we talk about how to deal with an unresponsive diver underwater. We show you, once you've got them to the surface, how to remove that equipment. And we also made a video on different ventilation methods, pocket mask or mouth to mouth, and how you'd efficiently give effective rescue breathing to somebody. So you've surfaced with somebody, or somebody needs your assistance to get back. Now, obviously the distance you are from the shore will dictate what you're next going to do. But what you need to think about is whether removing any of your equipment will actually help you or not. For example, you could remove your cylinders, and this would definitely speed up your efficiency on the surface. However, if the surface conditions are rough, you have large waves everywhere, then keeping your cylinders on and using your regulators is the sensible solution. Now, if you both removed all of your equipment, you should be buoyant in the exposure suits you're wearing, and that may be a fastest way to move on the surface and get you back. But the question here is speed really that important? And also, this is not a life-threatening emergency. If somebody's just tired and needs assistance to get back, it's highly unlikely either of you want to part with any of your scuba equipment. So I'm not suggesting to do that. During our Sidemount Essentials training or technical diver courses, we always have divers practice different variations or methods of surface towing. This can be with just two cylinders in side mount, or even having multiple stage cylinders included as well. We are going to share with you three methods you can use for towing a diver on the surface, and which of those three I prefer the most, and when I might use the others. You will find people have different names for these tows. The first one I'm going to cover, we'll take a look at this from under the water. Now, the person who is being towed needs to make sure that they do inflate the BCD, not fully, but just enough to support them comfortably at the surface. One of the drawbacks to this tow is that you don't actually see where you're going without turning and twisting your body to take a look and then resume the towing. You are close to the diver, so communication is easy, but they cannot actually see you. And if they do turn their head to try and talk, then it usually ends up under the water. With side mount, this actually works quite well because the diver who is towing can hold on to the BCD shoulder straps, and you get plenty of clearance to actually make efficient kicks, as there's no back mount cylinder to be hitting your knees on. So I'd have to say it is a very effective way of towing somebody, and it's probably one of the most used, especially if we're talking about just towing somebody a short distance. You can see here, even with divers with multiple cylinders, it's not too much of a problem. Yes, we have easy surface conditions. If you're like me and don't really like the flutter kick, then you can absolutely use the frog kick. This toe is also called a tank valve toe. However, in Sidemount, we don't have our tank valves there, so you definitely need to use those shoulder straps, which is actually very comfortable. Next, we're going to look at another toe. This time, the tire diver extends one of their arms out. The person assisting puts one hand into their armpit and the other hand helps keep their arm extended out. This puts you parallel with the diver. It does work. You do have good clearance. You can definitely talk to the person as your faces are very close to each other. However, this is probably my least preferred method of towing somebody. It generally feels quite awkward trying to lift the arm and also propel yourself forwards. So it's not really one that I use that often. The next method is probably a favorite for quite a few people. This one is what I'm calling the fin push, sometimes referred to as Mickey Mouse, as you have the diver's fins either side of your head looking like big ears. So some tips here. Don't put the diver's heels on top of your shoulder. Have them like you see here, with their feet pushing into your shoulders. You definitely don't need to be kicking as hard as you see the diver doing here. Your hands go on the diver's shins, just below the knees and near the feet. This way you can press down a little. Now, you're not able to communicate with them very efficiently from here, but like you can see here, using nice, slow, efficient frog kicks, you can actually cover a very long distance using this toe. So for distance towing, this is definitely my preferred option. If you have any questions on any of these toes, got anything you want to share, please drop a comment on the video. If you have any suggestions for other content you like to see, please keep them coming into us, and absolutely we'll do our best to keep making content like you see here.